Laurence, you mentioned this Tory sleaze row. I don't know if this particular individual is connected with this particular story about the financing of Downing Street's personal flat renovation, where it's been revealed that a Tory donor paid £52,000 for the wallpaper to be replaced, and the Conservative Party has been fined £17,800 after lying and denying the donation. I mean, if you see that wallpaper, talk about... talk about the wrong image for a kind of Marie Antoinette lifestyle for Boris. It looks worse than any European, Eastern European dictator would ever have had. I think the symbolism is kind of pretty terrifying, Laurence.
Yeah, absolutely. It's just another example of I'm one rule for thee and one rule for me. You know, the arrogance to go and to do it in the first place. I mean, rumours abound throughout UK politics that Boris Johnson is in serious financial trouble personally anyway. So we're watching this. It's an utter disdain for the rules, for the regulations, for decency, for leadership. You cannot, the one thing you have to be as a leader is unimpeachable. Do you know what I mean? Don't be corrupt and head up a government. And I just think it's just all falling down around him now. And it's, you know, I don't wish ill on anybody, but I find it very, very hard to be patient with the way that this government have behaved over a variety of things, the stupid wallpaper being just one of them. But the Labour leader thought he'd try and score some political capital by going off. Instead of doing something about it, these people, it's all theatre to them. He thought he'd go off to John Lewis and he tweeted a picture of himself holding some wallpaper. It's like, come on, I'm more serious than you lot. It's appalling.